fantastic.
Thank God we're given this opportunity to study the Bible together. Today we are going to study the book of Galatians. Galatians is one of the epistles written by Paul.
是保罗所写的其中一本书。
This book is quite an important book to the church today. Yeah.
这本书对今天的教会来讲也是很重要的。
Because here the book teaches us different things with regards to how to build up the church of God.
这里教导我们不同的。 这种事情怎么样来去把神的教会建立起来
Know that when we read chapter 1 verse 2
如果我们读第一章的第二节
Paul did not refer to a church here he refers to a group of churches
这里不是保罗写信不是只是给一间教会 而是可以说是各地的教会
Here it says and all the brethren who are with me to the churches of Galatia
他说和一切与我同在的众弟兄写信给加拉太的各教会
So if I can put it this way it means that in this Galatia this district of Galatia they were quite a few churches established.
所以说在加拉太这个地区啊，可能有好几间教会已经建立起来了。
Some people say that these churches were situated in the northern parts of Galatia.
有些人说这些教会呢是建立在，就是设立在北边的加拉太的北边。
The traditional belief is that the churches were situated in the south.
一开始的相信就是说，他们这些相信这些教会是在南边设立的。
I personally more inclined to believe that the churches were situated in the south.
我也比较相信就是说，这些教会是设立在这些南边的。
When you read the Acts of the Apostle, if you trace the movement of Paul and Barnabas.
如果我们看使徒行传来去看保罗跟巴拿巴的行程的话
From chapter 13 onwards to chapter 14 we find that they established quite a few churches
如果我们看13章,
on this trip
13章14章的话 他们在这一次的旅行当中 他们就是建立了好几间教会
So the traditional view is that the churches here are the churches in Galatia, situated in the south.
原本的这个认识就是说，这些这里的建立的教会应该是在加拉太的这种南边。
Today we are not going to enter into a debate over the location of these churches.
今天晚上，今天我们不是来去就是说辩论说这个教会到底是在南边或者是在北边。
Obviously, Paul wrote to them with a clear intention in mind, that is to help this group of churches. To come back to the right path of the truth.
但是这个写信的目的是保罗要帮助这些各地的教会来去再一次走回这正确的真理真道上。
So when you look at this book, basically it can be split into two parts.
这本书可以大致上分为两个部分。
Chapter 1 to Chapter 4 centered upon some theological arguments.
就是说，在第一章到第四章，这里是讲到一些神学论的一些，就是一些真理的辩护。
And this chapter 5 to chapter 6 on Christian living.
第五章、第六章就讲到基督徒的生活。
One of the key characteristics of the book is that Paul mentioned about the position in which he was.
其中提到的就是保罗说他的这个，就是说他的身份是什么？
The position that he was in after his conversion has nothing to do with his own making.
就是说他信主之后他的身份不是他自己所就是说自己去造出来的。
He was trying to portray to the church that his position was brought about by Christ.
就是说他的身份是基督让他有的。
Because through the work of Christ on him, he was given this position to lead the church.
就是说基督借着他 给了他这个身份来让他来去带领这些教会。
In this book, I believe we can also learn how to work together as a team or amongst workers or co-workers.
这本书我们也可以学习到怎么样来去一体整体的来去工作，同龄，就是同工之间怎么样来一起做事情。
When you look at the establishment of the church, in the time of the apostle,
在使徒时代教会的建立我们可以看得到。
We find that one of the key points is about how the workers were taught to come together, to work together as one unit.
其中一个重点就是讲到这些工人怎么一起来去同工来去做事情。
When you study, for example, Acts chapter chapter 1, starting from chapter 1.
比如说我们看 使徒行传的第一章开始。
We were told that they gathered together in one place.
发觉到他们是聚集在一个地方。
Though the statement is very simple.
虽然这一句话是很简单。
It speaks volumes of the mindset of the people at the time, how they have changed themselves.
告诉我们当时的人的心态的改变是怎么样的。
That's why they gathered together as one one body of people, and that were there to wait for the coming of the Spirit.
他们这一体的人就聚集在一起来这里等待圣灵的降临。
So true enough, the Spirit came upon them mightily and transformed them, transformed the church altogether.
真的圣灵降临，大大的降临在身上就改变了当时的教会。
This is how the church was first established.
这就是教会怎么样开始来去设立的。
So we find that one of the key areas for Satan to attack is to disrupt the unity in the church.
所以魔鬼的其中一个方式来去使到教会不和，就是来去 使到教会没有这个同心。
Again, we can see that this work of Satan very clearly, prominently in the book of Acts.
在使徒行传我们看到撒旦也是在这方面来去工作。
So without exception, when we come to the churches in Galatia, the unity in the church here was also badly disrupted.
没有什么不同的，在加拉太我们看到就是说教会这方面也受到很大的影响。
So today we know that we are the end times true church believers.
我们知道我们现今是末世的真教会的信徒。
Not only we have been entrusted with the missions to reach out to the unbelieving world.
不但只我们有这个责任要来传福音给这不幸的世界。
More importantly, we must learn to maintain the unity in the church.
最重要我们要保持教会里面的这个合一的心。
We see that if there is unity in the church, surely we can feel the presence of God.
当教会里面有合一的心，你会发觉到神的同在。
We'll feel that the church will begin to grow and will begin to multiply.
发觉到教会就开始成长。
So in serving God in the church,
所以在教会服侍神。
It is not just about how I want to serve.
不是说我怎么样来去服侍神。
I must learn how to serve in a team.
就是说学习怎么 怎么在一组人当中来去一起来去服侍。
This is a very important task for us all.
这是我们很重要的一项工作。
When there is a difference in opinion,
当我们的观念不同的时候，
How should we go about resolving the difference?
我们之间的不同，我们怎么样来去调和呢？
How should we go about accepting one another?
怎么样来去彼此来去接待呢？
In fact, this is what Christ wants to see in His church.
也就是这也是基督要我们在教会里面看得到的。
And because of that, we see that on our part, there is a lot of work that to be done in terms of spiritual cultivation.
所以在我们个人的灵修方面要下很大的功夫。
So that we can truly work towards a unity in the church.
直到我们真的朝着这个教会里的合一来去来去做。
I will spend a bit of time to talk about some of the key points in the book of Galatians.
花点时间讲一下加拉太书里面的一些重点。
Before I concludeyou are free to ask questions, or if you have any point that you want to bring out to share, whatever, you are free to do so.
结束之前我们大家可以来去，如果你有什么要讲的，可以来去彼此分享。
Now we are going to look at some key points.
我们看
in chapter 1.
我们看第一章里面的一些重点。
Now, one of the key points is that Paul was quite surprised to see that the converts inthe area of Galatia leave the truth promptly.
就是说其中一个重点就是说保罗很稀奇当时在加拉太信主的人这么快就离开了这个福音。
They first received the gospel heartily with hearts of joy.
他们一开始是全心的热意的很喜乐的来去 接受这个福音。
I believe truly the gospel must have touched their hearts if we read Acts chapter 13 and chapter 14.
如果我们看《使徒行传》十三章、十四章，你发觉到这个福音真的是感动了他们的心。
There is no way that we can deny that at that point in time the Spirit was working mightily.
可以看得到当时不可否认的神的灵在当时是很大的工作。
Yet when we read the book of Galatians, we find that their faith was being challenged.
但是在加拉太书的时候，我们发觉到他们的信仰就受到这个挑战。
So what can we learn from this incident here?
所以从这里我们能够学习到什么呢？
Maybe when we first came to believe, our faith was very fervent.
可能我们开始来相信的时候，我们的信心是非常的坚固的。
We have been touched by the power of the Spirit.
被圣灵的能力来去感动。
We truly believe that this is the truth and this is the church of God.
我们深深相信这是真理，这是神的教会。
We know that time is like a test to our faith.
我们知道时间就是我们信仰的考验。
After a while, we feel that we are challenged by many things that we encounter in life.
在生活上过后，我们发觉到就受到很大的影响和挑战。
Just like the believers at Galatia in Galatia.
就好像这些在加拉太的信徒一样。
It's like they were exposed to different challenges, such as different philosophies andschool of thoughts concerning religions.
他们就被那种世上的一般的那种信仰的这种道理，这种小说来去受到影响，受到挑战。
So in that's why Paul tells us.
所以保罗告诉我们。
In fear and in trembling, we work out our salvation.
我们应该是恐惧战惊的做成我们得救的功夫。
Meaning that at every phase of our belief, there must be this fear of God, fear for God.
就说我们信我们信仰的每一个阶段，我们要有这个敬畏神的心。
When this reverence for God is no longer there in our life.
当我们这个敬畏神的心逝去了之后，
we see that the old self, which has been crucified long time ago, would be resurrected and to do the work of destruction.
我们这个旧人已经是同钉十字架的，会再复活起来，再影响我们的信仰。
So we find that these people were affected.
所以你发觉到这些人就受到了影响。
So we must be very alert and careful with what we have believed in.
所以我们对我们所相信的要非常的谨慎、警醒的。
When we talk about belief,
当我们讲到我们这个信仰的时候，
we have been taught aboutwhat we have to believe in.
我们已经被教导我们应该要相信的是什么。
And we need to hold on to what we have believed in.
我们也要持守着我们所相信的。
Because this has been given to us by God and has been given to the church.
因为这是神给我们的，也是给了这个教会。
That's why when Paul wrote to different believers in different places,
所以当保罗写信给不同啊各地方的信徒的时候、
I think he mentioned some very important points.
啊，他就提到一些啊重要的一些重点。
We turn to Romans chapter 6.
我们看罗马书的第六章。
Romans chapter 6.
罗马书的第六章。
We read verse 17.
我们看第十七节。
Romans chapter 6 verse 17.
啊，第六章的第十七节。
But God be thanked that though you were slaves of sin, yet you obeyed from the heart that form of doctrine to which you were delivered.
感谢神，因为你们从前虽然做罪的奴仆，现今却从心里顺服了所传给你们道理上的模范。
Here it talks about the form of doctrine to which we have been delivered.
所以这里说到我们所传给我们的这种道理的这个规模。
That's why we find that in the church, we have a patterns of sound words, we have a form of belief.
所以在教会里我们的道理就是说道理是有一个规模的。
We were given this patterns of sound words.
这个道理的这个模范已经给了我们。
And by believing in it, we were saved.
但我们相信的话，我们就能够得救。
So, since we have received this form of belief,
既然我们有这样的一个规模的道理，
at no cost we can wander away from this form.
我们不应该就是离开了这个道理的这个模范。
This is very important foundation for us to know.
这是我们信仰的根基，我们要知道。
That's why we find that the believers in Galatia, they wandered away from this patterns of the sound words, this form of belief or doctrines.
也就是说，当时的加拉太的信徒就离开了这个道理的这个模范。
I want you to read another verse here.
我们再来看另外一节。
We turn to Second Timothy.
我们看提摩太后书。
Second Timothy.
提摩太后书。
Chapter 1.
第一章。
We read verse 13 and 14.
我们看第三十三节十四节。
Now, hold fast the pattern of sound words which you have heard from me in faith and love which are in Christ Jesus.
你从我听的那纯正话语的规模要用在基督耶稣里的信心和爱心常常守着。
Verse 14.
十四节。
That good things which was committed to you keep by the Holy Spirit who dwells in you.
从前所交托你的善道要靠着那住在我们心里面的圣灵牢牢的守着。
I think from the statement of Paul here, can deduce that why members of believers in Galatia eventually depart from the truth.
所以从这里我们发觉到当时的加拉太的信徒为什么会离开这个真道。
First of all, obviously they were not cautious.
一开始他们是不谨慎的。
Secondly, they have not keep what they have received by the power of the Holy Spirit. And who dwells in them.
第二，他们没有靠着这个圣灵来去守着这个道理。
So the truth that we have received.
所以这个真理我们所接受的。
How can we keep the truth?
我们怎么来去守着它呢？
By praying about it.
要来去祷告。
Ask the Lord to help us by the power of the Spirit that we can keep the word.
求神帮助我们，借着圣灵的能力，我们能够守着这个道理。
Otherwise, our faith can crumble when we face with challenges.
不然的话，我们信仰会崩溃，当我们遇到这个挑战的时候。
We know that we all have this propensity to be drawn to new things.
我们知道我们有这种就是一种心态，就是说当有新的东西出现的时候，我们会有这个兴趣。
This is human nature.
这是人的性情。
If you look at the world today, even when we talk about politics, they always talk about something new.
当我们甚至看这个世界，当我们讲到这个政治的时候，他们常常就提倡所谓的新的东西。
We know that.Newness of things can draw the hearts of people away.
所谓的新的事情能够把人的心来去挪去。
But the word of God is different.
但是神的话是不同的。
The word of God is unchanging.
神的话是不改变的。
We must understand that the church has been given a pattern, the patterns of sound words.
所以我们要知道，就是说教会是已经给了那个纯正话语的规模。
Now think about this.
我们这样来去想。
When you first came to the church.
当你 首先啊，第一次来到教会的时候
，or when you were first taught the word of God，
啊，当你被啊教导神的话语的时候
，you were convinced in your heart that that was true，
啊，因为在你心里你是深深相信这是真的。
And after a while, it seems that you begin to doubt，
啊，但是过后你发觉后你开始怀疑了。
Where does the problem lie？
啊，这个问题在哪里呢？
The problem could be that we have not prayed in the Spirit to keep the sound word。
啊，可能问题是说我们没有在灵里祷告来去守着这个纯正的话语。
I think this is very, very important。
啊，这是非常的重要。
So each time when we pray，
啊，所以每次当我们祷告的时候
，we pray that we can keep the word， the sound word of God through the help of the Spirit。
啊，我们应该借着圣灵来去啊守着这个纯正的话语。
Otherwise, we can be drawn away by you know.Theologians from outside the church, out with the church.
不然我们会被所谓的外教的这种神学论者来去其实影响到我们。
We'll feel that, oh, after all, what they said also true.
因为之后我们也会发觉到，哦，可能他们所讲的也是真的。
Maybe we need to join them as well to listen to them. After all, we can also, you know, get some teachings from them.
不然的话，我们也可以来去参与一下他们，这样我们从当中呢，也可以得到一些。
When our heart is moving towards that direction，
当我们心有朝向这个方向的时候
，it means that we have not relied on the Spirit to pray about the things that we have received from God。
也就是说，我们有来去依靠神，来去求神帮助我们，我们从神那里所领受的。
To pray that we can keep what we have received。
来去祷告求神来帮助我们，使到我们能够守着我们所有的。
If we cannot keep it, obviously we can be easily deceived。
不能够守着的话，当然就是说会被来去。被欺骗。
So we see that when we study the book of Galatians，
所以当我们来去查考加拉太书的时候
，one of the problems that cause disunity in the church is because some believers have been swayed by false teachings。
所以教会里面没有这个同心，也是当中信徒当中有一些被这些假教义来去影响了。
I want you to turn back to Galatians chapter 1。
我们看回加拉太书的第一章。
Galatians chapter 1。
加拉太书的第一章。
We read verse 1 and verse 7。
我们看第一节还有第七节。
I marvel that you are turning away so soon from him who called you in the grace of Christ to a different gospel。
第六节我稀奇你们这么快离开那借着基督之恩召你们的去从别的福音。
Here Paul was marveled by the fact that these people could so soon turn away from the true gospel。
保罗非常的奇怪，就是这些人怎么这么快就离开了这个真道。
Now I want you to pay attention to verse 7 as well。
我们来看第七节。
Here he said, which is not another, but there are some who trouble you and want to pervert the gospel of Christ。
那并不是福音，不过有些人搞乱你们，要把基督的福音更改了。
Turning away is the action taken by the believers。
那些离开是这些信徒的一个决定。
Why did they turn away？
为什么他们要离开呢
？Obviously, there must be some reasons。
当然离开当然是有这个理由的。
And the reason is that because some had perverted the gospel of Christ。
因为有些人因为其中理由就是有些人更改了这个福音。
How is it that the perversion of the gospel could lead to someone？Turning away from God。
这个更改福音为什么会使到一些人呢也离开了这个福音呢？
There is a key verse, a key word here。
这里有一个很重要的一个字眼。
I think which Paul has used it time and time again。
保罗常常都来去用到的。
That is the word trouble。
也就是搞扰。
Verse 7 says there are some who trouble you。
有些人。第七节这里说有些人搞扰你们。
I want you to read the same book chapter 5。
我们看第五章。
We read the verse 10。
第五章的第十节。
Chapter 5 verse 10。
第五章的第十节。
I have confidence in you in the Lord that you will have no other mind, but he who troubles you shall bear his judgment, whoever he is。
我在主里很信你们，必不怀别样的心，但搞扰你们的，无论是谁，必担当他的罪。
Again, Paul says that these people trouble the church。
所以再一次，保罗这里提到这些人来去搞扰这个教会。
We read verse 12。
我们看第十二节。
I could wish that those who trouble you would even cut themselves off.
啊，恨不得那些搞扰你们的人把自己隔绝了。
So the word trouble is used.
啊，所以这里讲到这个搞扰。
In fact, this word is also used in Acts of the Apostle.
啊，在使徒行传我们也看到这个字眼。
We can turn to chapter 15.
十五章。
Chapter 15.
使徒行传的十五章。
So by looking at chapter 15, we know that what the Judean believers preach is not from God.
所以从十五章我们看到那犹大信主的这些人传的福音不是从神那里来的。
It is not something that new to the church at the time.
其实对教会当时也不是新的一件事情。
We read chapter 15.
我们看第十五章。
We read verse 19.
十五章的第十九节。
Chapter 15, verse 19.
十五章的十九节。
Therefore, I judge that we should not trouble those from among the Gentiles who are turning to God.
所以据我的意见，不可为难那归附神的外邦人。
So words can trouble us.
所以有时候话语能够为难我们，或者是
So does a false teaching.
甚至这假道也是一样。
We read the verse 24 is even clearer.
24节也是再一次讲明。
Since we have heard that some who went out from us have troubled you with words.
我们听说有几个人从我们这里出去用言语搞扰你们。
Unsettling your souls.
祸乱你的心。
You find that when a person is troubled,
所以你发觉到当一个人被搞扰的时候
the soul or the heart become unsettled.
就发觉到他的心呢是有一些疑惑的。
When a person's heart is unsettled, obviously he would like to look for a solution to his problem.
当他心不平静的时候，他就要找到一个理由，就是找到一个方法使到他心平静。
So we find that when a false teaching is preached,
所以发觉到当一个假的道理传出去的时候
why is it that some people are able to resist it very well?
为什么有些人能够抵挡这些假道呢？
Because they have prayed about the belief that they have received.
因为他们对他们所相信起初所相信的有来去好好的祷告。
Because they keep the word that they have received through the power of the Spirit.
因为他们借着圣灵的能力来守着他们起初所相信的。
That's why when this false teaching is preached,
所以当这些假道传出去的时候
they are not troubled.
他们没有被搞扰。
Because the faith within is strong.
因为他们的信心在里面是坚固的。
The Holy Spirit is within them to help them.
因为圣灵在里面来帮助他们。
So this is something that we need to understand.
这是我们要了解的。
And when you start to doubt the faith that you have received,
当你开始怀疑你所相信的这个真理的时候
that is the sign of danger.
这也是一个危险的一个记号。
But you also have to pray extra hard about it.
你应该花更大的功夫来去祷告。
So that you can keep the faith that you have once received from the church.
来好好的来去守着你起初从教会所领受的这个信仰。
You find that when the truth is not pure anymore.
你发觉到当这个真理不再纯正的时候
serving God becomes a big problem.
你发觉到服侍神就成为一个很大的问题。
How are you going to encourage the brothers and sisters?
你怎么样来去勉励这些弟兄姐妹
呢？ If there are two different sets of teaching in the church.
如果在教会里面有两种不同的道理。
And yet they are mutually exclusive.
而且是很各自来是隔离的分
开的 and they repel one another.
而且是敌对的
How are we going to preach?
怎么样来去传呢？
How can we work together as one?
怎么来一起来去工作呢？
It's not possible.
这是不可能的。
When we talk about the truth, it's not about tolerance.
当我们讲到真理的时候，不是容忍。
We need to make it clear.
我们要讲清讲明。
Because we have the Holy Spirit.
因为我们有圣灵的同在。
How was the church established? First established.
教会一开始是怎么样来去成立的呢？
How was the truth first given?
这个真理是怎么样来去先给予教会的呢？
By the power of the Holy Spirit.
借着圣灵的能力。
So.We need to understand this.
所以我们要来去明白。
We must not be troubled by the any words that we heard.
所以我们不要被我们所听到的一些话语来去搞扰。
Otherwise, our soul can become very unsettled.
不然的，我们的心呢会很不平静。
We need to understand one very important point.
我们要记得一个很重要的一点。
When you look at the incidents of Adam and Eve,
当我们看到亚当夏娃的这个事情的时候
sometime when God talked about His commandment,
当神讲他的诫命的时候
He did not explain too much.
他没有就是说解释的太多。
He said to Adam and Eve,
就是像亚当跟夏娃这么说
You should not eat of it.
你不可以吃。
The day you eat of it, you shall surely die. That full stop.
你吃的，你必定死，就是这样。
No explanation given.
没有解释。
But when you look at the proposition put forth by Satan.
当撒旦来去讲明这个所谓的他讲明的这个道理的时候
，It seems very appealing to the listeners at the time.
他讲的时候看起来对听的听众是非常洗耳恭听
的。But he said you may not die.
他说你不一定死。
After you have eaten it.
当你吃了之后
，Your eyes will be brightened up.
你的眼睛会明亮。
You will be like God.
你好像神一样。
You will know good and evil.
你就能够分辨善或恶。
These are the things that God has never said.
这些事情神是没有讲过的。
So sometimes to hold on to the truth is pretty difficult.
所以有时候要持守这个真理是挺困难的。
We need submission and obedience and a heart of humility to accept.
我们需要有一个谦卑的心、顺服的心来去做。
When there is no humility on our part.
当我们个人没有这个谦卑的心的时候。
Sooner or later, we'll be drawn away from the faith.
迟早我们会被就是说会离开这个真道。
If you look at the history of the True Jesus Church.
甚至我们看真耶稣教会的历史。
There have been many wonderful workers in the past.
之前我们有很多很伟大的工人。
You know, yesterday I was talking to a truth seeker.
昨天我跟一个慕道者来谈天的时候。
He came from Malaysia.
是从马来西亚过来。
He knew the history. He knows the history of the church very well.True Jesus Church.
他对真耶稣教会的历史是非常的了解。
That's why he asked me.
所以他问我。
What happened to the True Jesus Church in Ipoh?
他说
Ipoh, West Malaysia.
西马的怡保教会的那个真耶稣教会怎么样了？
You know they split. I was quite surprised. How is it that he knew about our history?
因为当时那当地的教会他们就分开两间教会，那他们他。我也很稀奇，他怎么会知道这个事情呢？
So my answer to the question is this.
说我的答案对他所问的问题就是
the church is true.
我说教会是真。
The truth is true.
这个真理就是真理咯。
But people are not perfect, are not humble.
那人不是完全，他们不是人不够谦卑。
If you look into the reason as to why some left the church at the time.
如果你看当时的情况，为什么有些信徒会离开教会
？First, because they did not have this humility.
首先他们没有这个谦卑的心。
No humility means no understanding from God.
没有谦卑的心就没有从神来的一种了解。
Because God opposes the proud.
因为神是阻挡谦卑骄傲的人。
So if God opposes someone, how is it that He will still give wisdom to that person?
如果神阻挡一个人的话，神怎么会把这个智慧给那个人呢？
Surely not possible.
这是不可能的事情。
So when there is humility to accept what has been taught.
所以当你有这个谦卑的心来去接受你被教导的。
You will get more wisdom to understand the word of God.
你会从神那里得到更多的智慧来更
加了解。Your faith will be deepened.
你的信心会更加的坚固。
You begin to understand that truly this is the wonderful work of God that He has shown to the church.
你会更加的了解，真的就是神在教会里的这个奇妙的这个真理。
So if everyone can keep the faith in this manner,
如果每个人都这样来去守着这个信仰的话
，then the church will become a very powerful church to manifest the manifold wisdom of God.
那教会就有这个很大的能力来彰显出神各百般的智慧。
Turn to Ephesians.
我们看以弗所书
Chapter 3.
以弗所书的第三章
Ephesians Chapter 3.
以弗所书的第三章
We read verse 10.
我们看第十节
We read from verse 9.
我们看第九节
And to make all people see what is the fellowship of the mystery which from the beginning of the ages has been hidden in God who created all things through Jesus Christ. Verse 10. To the intent that now the manifold wisdom of God might be made known by the church to the principality and powers in the heavenly places.
又使众人都明白 这历代以来隐藏在创造万物之神里的奥秘如何安排的，为要借着教会使天上执政的掌权的现在得知神百般的智慧。
How is God going to manifest His wisdom?
神怎么来去彰显出他的百般的智慧
？Through His church.
就是借着教会。
Through you and I.
就借着你跟我。
So before we can carry out this massive task that the Lord has given to us.
在我们还没有能够来去行出神给我们这个这么大的工作之前
，we have to make sure that we are able to keep it through the power of the Holy Spirit.
首先我们要靠着圣灵来去守着神的道理。
And always tell us, pray to God.
我们告诉自己，我们要向神来去祷告。
God, we want to be humble before you.
我们要在你的面前来去谦卑。
No humility, we will lose the presence of God.
没有谦卑的话，我们就会离弃就是神的同在。
So we see that when you look at the history of the true Jesus Church.
所以当我们看真耶稣教会的历史的时候。
Why is it that some people left, even though they were so powerful initially?
为什么有些人一开始起初的时候是这么有能力，还是最终离开了？
I think if we trace all the way down to the root cause of the problem.
如果我们找出这个问题的根源。
We find that the answer is very clear.
这答案是非常的简单。
Lack of humility.
非常的清楚，就是缺乏谦卑。
So when we come to accepting God's word.
所以当我们来讲到来去接受神的话语的时候，
we have to pray always to make sure that the word that we have received can remain in us.
我们要常常来祷告，使到神的话语常常留在我们的心中。
Now we come back to the chapter one.
我们看回加拉太书的第一章。
And here Paul also talks about how he was called to become an apostle and apostle of Christ.
所以保罗在这里也提到他怎么被蒙召成为基督的使徒。
Again, I think there's a point here that needs a clarification.
我想这里有一点我们要来去澄清的。
Verse 12, yeah.
第12节。
For I neither received it from man, nor was I taught it.But it came through the revelation of Jesus Christ.
因为我不是从人领受的，也不是人教导我的，乃是从耶稣基督启示来的。
It seems that here Paul was a bit proud, isn't it?
看起来保罗在这里好像讲起来有点骄傲。
How could he say to what he did?
他怎么可以这样来去说呢？
Said he received It not from man, but from God.
这怎么可以说我不是从人领受的也不是人教导的，是从神而来的。
Sometimes this can be misleading if we do not understand it correctly.
如果我们不正确的了解，这是有误导性的。
Now, when you talk about receiving words from God, yeah?
当我们讲到从神那里来去接受，就是从神那里得启示。
Take Paul for example.
拿保罗来做个比喻。
We know that when God first shone His light upon him.
我们知道一开始保罗是神用光来去照他的。
At that point in time, he knew nothing about the mystery of God.
当时他根本不了解神的这个奥秘。
And then he was told to meet up with a brother called Ananias.
之后他被就是说被指示要跟亚拿尼亚来去见面。
And he was baptized.
他受洗了。
That is a very important point.
那是很重要的一点。
Revelation was given to him.
这个启示这样给他。
After he has been baptized into Christ.
就是他进入基督的身体洗礼之后。
He has come under the protection of God.
就是说他已经进入了这个神里面的一种保护。
He was part of the setup of the apostolic church.
也就是说他是在使徒教会这个建立当中。
He was in Christ Jesus.
他在耶稣基督里面。
We turn to Colossians.
我们先看哥罗西书。
Colossians chapter 2.
哥罗西书的第二章。
We read verse 2 and verse 3.
哥罗西书第二章，我们看第二节、第三节。
That their hearts may be encouraged, being knit together in love and attaining to all riches, of the full assurance of understanding, to the knowledge of the mystery of God, both of the Father and of Christ. Verse 3. In whom are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge.
第二节要叫你们的心得安慰，因为、爱心互相联络，以致丰丰足足的在悟性中有充足的信心，使他们真知道神的奥秘，就是基督所积存的一切智慧知识都在他们里面藏着。
In whom? In Christ.
在哪里？就是在基督里。
Paul was baptized into Christ.
保罗受洗归入基督。
So it was not at all surprised to see that he received a wisdom or revelation from God.
所以不稀奇的，他从基督那里得到这个启示，这个智慧。
But we see that it seems here is like a very quite a unique case.
所以看起来这里好像是一个很特别的一件事情。
But one thing is for certain is that he was in Christ already.
我们可以肯定的就是他已经受洗归入基督的身体了。
Paul says he received many great teachings. Doctrines.
他说保罗说他从基督那里得了很多关于道理的教训。
Now what did he do?
他怎么做呢？
Here we are told that he went up to Jerusalem.
你发觉到他上到耶路撒冷。
And obviously he must have discussed with the elders.
他也跟当时的这些长老来去讨论。
Maybe not all of them, but he has seen the face of Peter.
最起码他遇见这个彼得。
Now, one thing we need to understand.
但是有一点我们要明白的。
Whatever he preached.
他所传的。
Was accepted by the community of faith.
因为他所传的也是这个信仰的团体里面来去接受的。
When we read 2 Peter.
所以当我们读彼得后书的时候。
Even Peter endorsed his teachings.
甚至彼得也接受他的教训。
Let's assume that he had received a direct revelation from God.
就这样我们这样说了，他是真的直接从神那里得到启示。
But his teaching has to be endorsed.
他虽然接受直接的接受启示，他的教训也要人来去来去承认。
So the entire community of faith agreed to what he has received.
就是说整个团体信仰团体里面的人来去接受他所领受的。
We need to understand that God is not a God of confusion.
我们要明白神不是一个混乱的神。
God is a God of order.
神是一个有秩序的神。
That's why even though Paul received so much.
虽然保罗从神那里领受了这么多。
He went up to Jerusalem.
他也去到耶路撒冷。
We see that his teaching was accepted.
发觉到他所讲的道理，当时的领袖也是接受了。
Humility on his part.
你发觉到他的谦卑。
Now in the future, when you start serving the Lord in a more, we said, important role.
所以以后当你在就是说比较重要的岗位上来去服侍神的时候。
Then this is a very important principle to abide with.
这是一个很重要的原则，我们要来去做的，将来去做。
Because we are given this task to teach the church, to lead the church forward, so that the church can be built up in Christ Jesus.
因为我们给了这个责任来去带领教会，来去建立教会，在基督里建立起来。
So whatever you have received.
所以你所领受的。
It must be accepted by your co-workers.
就说你的同工一定也来去接受。
Because the Spirit of God will move them to understand and accept it.
因为神的灵也会感动他们。让他们了解来去接受。
Because the truth of God is the truth that set us free.
因为神的道理是使我们得自由的。
It brings about freedom in the church.
因为在教会里面会有这个真自由。
Your heart will not feel unsettled.
你发觉到你的心不会觉得很搞乱，很扰乱。
So when you have received a revelation from God, or whatever.
所以当你说你从基督那里得到启示的时候。
This is a very important point to bear in mind.
这是很重要的一点我们要记着的。
In fact, whatever Paul says is based on the scriptures as well.
其实保罗所讲的很多东西都是照着圣经来说的。
Even what Jesus said is based on the scriptures.
甚至耶稣基督所传讲的也是照着圣经来说的。
For example, in John chapter 7.
比如说约翰福音书的第七章。
Jesus talks about the coming of the Spirit.
耶稣讲到这个圣灵的降临。
He said, according to the scriptures.
他说照着圣经怎么说。
The foundation is the Bible.
这根基是圣经。
We can read John chapter 7.
我们看约翰福音书的第七章。
Verse 37.
我们看三十七节。
On the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out, saying, If anyone thirst, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me, as the scriptures have said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water.
节期的末日就是最大之日，耶稣站着高声说，人若渴了可以到我这里来，信我的人就如经上所说，从他腹中要流出活水的江河来。
I think 1 Corinthians is the same.
哥林多前书也是一样。
We read 1 Corinthians 15.
哥林多前书的第十五章。
Verse 3.
十五章的第三节。
For I delivered to you first of all that which I also received, that Christ died for our sin according to the scriptures.
我当日所领受又传给你们的，第一就是基督照着圣经所说的为我们的罪死了。
Here it talks about what he has received.
这里讲到保罗所领受的。
But what he received is in line with the scriptures.
他所领受跟圣经所讲的是一致的。
If you look at what Paul has received,
如果我们看保罗所领受的。
The main focus is on Christ, about Christ and his work and his sacrifice and his resurrection.
保罗所领受是关于基督，基督的工作，基督的牺牲，基督的复活。
So this is the mentality that we need to have.
这一种这种心态我们必须要有的。
If we have received something new.
如果我们所谓领受一些新的东西。
Or different view concerning the scriptures.
或者不同从不同的角度来看圣经。
Consult your coworkers.
跟你的同工来去来去商量一下。
Pray about it.
祷告一下。
So that the Spirit will move them to understand as well if what we have received is exactly in accordance to the scriptures.
直到圣灵也感动他们，直到你所领受的也是照着圣经的道理。
This requires a lot of humility.
这需要很多的很大的一种谦卑。
Otherwise, it's difficult.
不然的话就很困难。
Secondly,
第二点
，whatever we receive,
我们所领受的
must be based on the Bible.
一定要根据圣经。
In this way, we will not go astray.
这样的话，我们就不会偏离了。
We have a few minutes break.
我们休息几分钟。
Let's pray in silence.
我们默祷。